A very warm welcome to all the delegates of this international conference. I welcome you all from India. I, Dr. Shivanas, Assistant Professor, Department of English, RTMM, Allahabad, India. I also thank Dr. Arburim Isini to give me such a wonderful platform to express my view. The title of my paper is Literature as a Transitional Force in Uplifting Dalit and Other Marginalized Classes in India. It is believed that pen is mightier than the sword since ages, and has been proved also, as we see writers who have been continuously inspiring people from generation to fight against many injustices and tyranny existing in the society. And many writers have been successful in their attempts too. When it comes to India, we see that injustices have been meted out to some specific classes which are considered as marginalized, and they have been living under subjugation since centuries. As we all know, marginalized classes are those classes which have been considered as people of lesser importance by other groups. Those are in power or consider themselves superiors to them. When it comes to India, there are certain classes which are considered as marginalized, for example, Dalit tribal. This list also includes women and transgender. From time to time, there have been debates on Dalit and other marginalized classes in Indian social political milieu, and which keeps on going in the contemporary scenario as well. The fact is that when we discuss the term marginalized classes, then India being a patriarchal society, then women also come in the category, as they have been subjugated since centuries. One of the class which has been very less discussed in the history is the term transgender, which also need attention, as it is also one of the most deprived class. So I am trying to highlight the pains and suffering and how the writer have tried to reform these marginalized classes through their writing. Marginalized or subaltern are those groups which are considered as inferior by other groups of the social political milieu. Sometimes these subaltern groups are deprived of basic rights and amenities as compared to other so-called superior groups. And it is in the case of Dalit, who were made to feel inferior since the caste system came into force in India. By the upper classes, they are forced to the periphery or the edge of the society. They were humiliated and were forced to live a life of pains and suffering. But now things are different, as the Constitution of India gives equal rights and opportunities to every citizen of the country. Our Constitution strictly asks us to celebrate the diversity of our population and treats all its citizens as equal irrespective of caste, creed, religion and gender. This transformation has not happened abruptly, but it has taken long time. This drastic change is the effort of many reformers as well as writers. People hardly know that in India, the Dalit reform movement can be traced back from the age of Bhakti movement. The Bhakti cult was a secular movement in the history of India, which was also believed in removing inequality existing in the society on the basis of caste. Poet, philosopher Kavi and Raidas advocated equality among various sections of the society. Even many of their followers followed their part belief in the uniform society. During British rule, thinkers like Jyotiba Phule, Periya, B.R. Ambedkar and freedom fighters like Mahatma Gandhi took the initiative and started the Dalit reform movement. This got the spark from the black movement of contemporary America. Lots of factors have also contributed to the rise of Dalit in India. One such factor is the power of pen. There have been many studies on Dalit which deal with their social mobility, economic development, social, economic and political status, atrocity, ideology, identity and so on, contributing to their upliftment. Recently, there has been tremendous rise in Dalit literature across India. Now we see Dalit literature, it is believed that one of the first Dalit writers in the history of Madra Chennaiya was a popular saint in 11th century. He lived in the reign of Western Chalukya and was regarded by some scholars as the father of Vachana poetry. There are many writers belonging to the category, but the pioneer of Dalit writing in Marathi is Baburao Bagul. He published the first collection of stories, Jehwa Mi Jat Charuli. When it translated to English, it is When I Had Conceived My Caste, which was published in 1963. It is a passionate depiction of a crude society and created a stir in Marathi literature. There are many other Dalit writers like Arun Kamble, Shantabai Krishna Kamble, Raja Dale, Namdev Dasal, Annabal Sathev, Bandhu Madhav, Lakshman Mani, Lakshman Gaikwad, Hari Naraki, Sharan Kumar Limbari, and the list goes on. The fact that when we discuss the term marginalized classes, the India being a patriarchal society, and so women also come in this category. They have been reformer who have worked for the upliftment of women since ages. Raja Ram Mohan Roy is one such personality who is credited with abolishing the unjust practice of sati and child marriage in India. There are two women educationists which have done a tremendous job in spreading women education in India. One such name is Savitribai Phule of Maharashtra, who was the first female teacher of India, and the other is Rukaiya Sakhawat Hussain, who opened the first girls' school in West Bengal. She is considered a harbinger of Muslim women's awakening and emancipation, a prolific Bengali writer, social worker, educationist, a voice of gender equality, and the champion of women liberation movement. Then we see Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, who also advocated the English education and especially women education. And now there have been lots of women writers and reformers who are writer as well as social activists. Kamla Bhasin was one such name, who is diplomat, who was diplomat, but she resigned her job in United Nations to work for the upliftment of Adivasi women, and for this purpose she founded Sangat, a feminist network. And we have another writer who is working in America, Chandra Talpate Mohanty. Then when it comes to transgender, there is very less work we see, but in the recent year we have seen this transgender activities have been taken wider step. We see the success of Lakshmi Narayan Tripathi and the Mahamandalation of Kinnar Akhada in Kumbh Allahabad 2019 is one fine example. So to conclude, we can say that all these marginalized classes, whether it is Dalit or women or transgender, have struggled hard to reach a respectable position in the society. And there are many writers who have tried their heart to uplift these classes by inspiring people to work for them. And there are still many writers who are trying to reform these marginalized classes by the power of their pen. Thank you.